What's up, everyone, and welcome to episode number 4 of our build series. If you've been paying attention and you've been following along, I really appreciate it. If you're new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button and the like button because it really helps with the algorithm and it pushes this content out to more people that are into motorcycles. In today's video, we're going to be putting together the lower end of our CB550. For this engine, I have some extremely cool parts, including a set of high compression pistons that I got from Dime City Cycles and a stock crankshaft that's been lightened and balanced. Now, when it comes to the crankshaft, there's people that are all for lightening and there's people that are extremely against it. Now, when people lighten the crankshaft, it can be referred to as knife edging. And knife edging is supposed to help the crankshaft move through the oil and the air in the crankcase a little bit easier. Now, in theory, I don't really see how this works because oil and air are being pushed all over the place and nothing is really constant. I don't really understand it, but we're gonna try it out and I'm gonna let you know how it goes. The other thing that's interesting to me is that the weight of the crankshaft, although it plays a huge part in the counterbalance of the piston, a lighter crankshaft is easier to spin. I'm hoping to get better throttle response in the mid to top end. And from what I've read on the forums, this is how you achieve it. Now, I've went ahead and thoroughly cleaned both cases of our engine. It's super important after you get things vapor blasted that you do a thorough cleaning because the media that they use to blast the cases and clean them, that stuff is super fine, and if it gets into your oil passages or is on a bearing surface, it may ruin something. So I've went ahead and cleaned everything. The only thing to do now is to put the engine together. These CB550s with the top and the bottom case, it's an extremely easy build, but let's jump into it. Now that the cases are together, we can move on to the pistons and the cylinders. I'm headed to the machine shop to pick up my parts, and I wanted to talk about why I always use the pros, even for the most basic hone job. Now, I'm sure you've seen people on YouTube use tools like this, or even that weird toilet brush looking thing, and there's definitely a specific time to use those. Let's say you just picked up a bike, pulled it apart, everything looks good. You're gonna use the same piston with brand new rings. Then a couple quick passes of one of those tools and you should be good to go. Not only did you deglaze the cylinder, but you put a crosshatch pattern in it that you know deep down inside isn't right, but if you look at it at the right angle, it's good enough. Here's where I see the issue. Those tools were not made to remove a bunch of material. They're more of a resurfacing tool. But you know what does remove material? Is piston rings. And over many cycles with the crankshaft, the piston ring will wear itself into a cylinder wall. And in our case, it's been doing that for the last 46 years. If you look at any piston, you'll notice that the piston ring is set below the top of the piston height, meaning that the piston ring does not travel the entire length of the cylinder. It typically stops a couple millimeters before the top of the bore. So if you're using the same piston with the same rings, then that doesn't really matter because you're gonna be in the same position in the cylinder for cylinder wear. Now in our case, if you look at our Wiseco piston compared to the stock piston, you'll notice that the wrist pin position is completely different than the stock one, and the ring position is a little bit higher in the bore. So if I were to use our new pistons in that old worn out cylinder and just cross hatch it, then the new piston ring would have to go through the worn spot of the cylinder and into brand new cylinder that's been untouched. Now that diameter may be microscopic, but you gotta remember the piston is traveling at incredible speeds and it's doing it millions of times. It could be like that thing's hitting a wall and potentially could lead to premature failure or the rings won't seal properly. When you bring your stuff to the pros, you know that your cylinders are gonna be straight. Not only that, they can control all of the variables and your crosshatch pattern is gonna be perfect. A good crosshatch pattern means that your rings are gonna seal properly and overall, get the most compression that you can out of your pistons. The shop I go to charges 30 to 40 bucks per hole. And if you think about it as cheap insurance for your $600 to $800 piston set, then I think it's well worth it. As with anything, you could probably get away by doing it at home in your garage, but just know it's at the expense of reliability and longevity. If I'm putting my hard earned money into an engine, I want the thing to last for a long time. And that's why I always bring it to a shop. Ain't looking for much of me.
Cause I really, really, really want you to know that I love you from the highest peak to low. There ain't nothing that will block our path to grow. We can work it out. If you're lost in the blue, just tell me what you lose. To open the door, loving some more. If you're found on the line, show me the right.
So let's talk about gapping the piston rings. Now, there's only two rings on the piston that need to be gapped. That's the first and the second one. There's another set of rings, which is your oil rails and your oil control ring, which they can go straight in, no problem. It's important to set ring gap because as the engine heats up, which is called thermal expansion, all of the parts grow with heat, the gap on the ring needs to be set properly. If not, then the rings will get a little bit too tight, and if they're too loose, then you may lose a little bit of compression or oil might seep through and you'll get that dreaded smoking engine. Now, it's pretty easy to do this at home and you can set your gaps pretty easily with a tool that's less than 30 bucks, but I always do it on mine because you don't wanna run into the issue where you didn't check and something could happen. Most piston companies will give you a data sheet or a recommendation for your ring gap for both the top and the bottom ring. In our case, they want us to measure the bore and times that by a number that's given to us on this sheet. So, to be specific, I've measured each one of our cylinders at 3 inches, 303 thousandths across all four. And I'm gonna times that by 0.0045 to give us our top ring gap. This comes out to 0.015. And that's what I'm gonna be setting all of the top rings across all four cylinders to. For the second ring, it's the same thing. You take the bore diameter and you times it by 0.0055. This, in our case, gives us an average of 0.018, and that's what all of the second rings will be set to. So now that we know the numbers that we need to hit for both our top and our bottom ring, it's just a matter of grinding them down and making sure that the gap is correct. What we need to do first is we need to insert whatever ring you want to start with. In our case, we're going to start with the top ring and measure the gap that's currently there. From the factory, they come gapped. If they didn't, then you're going to have to set your own gap and put like a thousandth of an inch in the ring before you can get started. But most of the time, a high-end piston company will definitely give you a little bit of a gap. From there, I will then take a feeler gauge and see what the gap is. If the gap is good, then there's nothing I need to do. If the gap is small, then that's where I'm gonna have to take out my ring grinding tool and grind down the ring just a little bit to achieve the desired gap. Now I'm gonna do this with both the top and the bottom ring. And there's a couple things you should know when it comes to grinding rings. There's a specific direction that you should be grinding. You need to be grinding from the outside in so that you don't chip the ridge of the ring and damage it. If you chip off one of the coatings or one of the edges of the ring, you might damage the ring and need to get another set, which sucks. I'm gonna do the same exact thing for the second ring, which actually is a little bit easier because the material is a little bit softer. So you need to be a little bit more careful when you're grinding the second ring, but it's the same thing. And I do that for all four piston ring sets on all the cylinders. I'll then mark the boxes and make sure that they go in that cylinder when I'm ready to assemble. All right, so we are ready to put the pistons and the cylinder back onto the engine. I have all the parts laid out here, including a gasket set that I got from Dime City Cycles. Now, when it comes to gaskets, it's super important that you get a reputable brand. The last thing you want to do is mess around with the cheap stuff and find out that you have a base gasket leak when you put the engine together. Start with a good brand and you can kind of guarantee that the gasket is not going to be the issue. Now, when it comes to the CB550, there's these two little jets, and these jets are probably the most important part in the engine. If you forget these and leave them out, then there's going to be no oil that gets to the top of the head. In return, you'll probably see something, and all the hard work that you just put into your engine is ruined. Make sure that you put those in the case. There's also an O-ring that goes around the bottom of it, and it seals it off. Now, on the cylinder, there's these special little orange O-rings, or typically orange O-rings, that go on the base of the cylinder. It's important that you do not forget those as well because it helps with sealing. All right, so I know I've been talking a lot in this episode, but there's just a couple more things that we need to talk about before the pistons go into the engine. First things first is the piston ring position on the piston itself. I've went ahead and marked our pistons to kind of show where those rings should land. The green line is for our second ring, the red line is for our top ring, the blue line is for the oil control ring, and the two black lines are for the oil control rings, the little tiny ones that go on top and bottom. Now, you'll also notice that there's an arrow on the piston. The arrow needs to be pointing towards the exhaust side. Double check with the sheet that came with the rings because it'll probably tell you what position that needs to be. Be careful with stars. Not every light is gonna guide you.
Yeah, when I blow up, I'ma soar high like Peter Pan. In real life, be living out my dreams. If I'm waking up, it's in a foreign land. Whole wrist covered up in ice. Dealership, never asked the price. I hit the molly ball with my dogs. Yeah, I swipe it once without thinking twice. Cause this what I was made for. Man, I know this what I came for. On a big stage, couple thousand people, and they do whatever I say so. Have chicks hair color of the rainbow. Yeah, chains on me like Django. Be a long way from my tank low, cause my Tesla charge for them bank rolls. And I'm grinding, money on my mind, and I'm headed to the top. I won't stop until I find it. Write my name in diamonds.
Last but not least, we are going to clean the cylinders with acetone or carb cleaner until they are absolutely spotless. I'm gonna put a little coat of fresh engine oil in every cylinder, and these things are ready to go back on. It's gonna guide you, baby. Don't let it rain on your spark. Keep it close to your heart. All of the pressure's gonna drive you crazy. Close your eyes to the madness. In the morning, it's all gonna vanish. Don't be afraid of the dark. Be careful with stars. Gonna guide you.
Since I blew up, everybody telling me that I'm the man. Same people gave me the finger, they reaching out for me to give a hand. In a different city and my pills came, cause this tour don't happen, I feel pain. And the girl with me said she down for life, she don't even know what's my real name. Just try and get what she came for. And ain't nothing I got safe though, cause when the money go wild, everybody get a piece. But it's looking like I ain't on the payroll. Got a big house made out of Play-Doh and a plastic crown for my halo. But still a long way from my tank low, cause my Tesla charged for the